Achoo. Whoa. There are my parts cut out. I'm going to stick them on. You see, that gives me my lip. I'm going to carve in a bit more after, but that gives me already the hatch lid lip. I'll stick these on with some permanent spray glue. It says it doesn't eat polystyrene, so hey, we can only hope, can't we? But that's some spray neoprene, so we'll give that a bash. I'll come back when they're on there. All right, lovely. Here we go. We've got this white foam now stuck down. I kind of had to do some relief cuts, else it keeps lifting. I use quite a lot, you know, I didn't want to go skimpy. If you've got something a little bit easier in terms of curvature and everything, then I'd leave it 5 minutes or so and then stick it together. But because of this, I found it was better to kind of stick it on, get it in position while it was still kind of wet. Just a little tip there. I've just got to tidy this edge up with a bit of a block. It's going to get covered. It's going to be carboned. It's going to be shaped. We're kind of getting there, you know what I mean? Little by little. Lovely. It's always tricky when you've got a glue joint, because one, the glue's harder, two, there's foam next to it either side, so your block, I'm just using the very sort of edge of it against the glue. Try and wipe that off, nice and light passes, don't go too heavy, else you'll dig in and bleh, it'll be horrible. Bleh, 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 bleh. Starting to round over, I'll start to get that more. It's already getting there. I don't mind having a double, you know, a double feature, if you like. It's just gonna add to the look. All right, guys, so I'm gonna carry on. I'm gonna get this all tarty smarty. This is gonna be where my hatch seal goes. Starts off flat like that. Made myself a little block, bit of foam, bit of sandpaper, and that basically fits in your back and forth you go. And that's creating a groove. Right, this is my lip. So I was wondering how to do that. I kind of came up with just a bit of block. It's gonna take a minute. Same with this, you know, I'll start against the foam. Just go back and forth. Got the Dremel out with my router bit in it. I'm gonna get into the corners now where I've been rubbing this groove away. I've got to get in now because I can only go so far into the corner because I put the little corner pieces in. We're filming, we're focusing. So I've dremeled out my corners. I'm going to get a smaller block or something, get in it. And then I'm going to start to build my hatches because I want them all curved and made the same. So I'll put some stringers under, cut to the same shape here. Because I can see through the board, so it's easier to fit the hatch, make sure it's sealing. Once I've bought my rubber thills, do a dry fit and make sure I'm the right depth and make sure the hatch is going to fit all the way around before I fiberglass, all right? I did end up channeling the piece here. Finished off just channeling for the jet drive to sit under that. If you want to become a waysider, you've got to be a little bit on the edge. Hit that like button. Boop, boop, boop. Bell. Like, subscribe. A few comments, guys, you know, leave me your comments, love comments. Welcome all of it, you know? This is one hatch, haven't done that back one yet. I just put a bit of foam in, drew around the backside, which gives me my bulkheads. Also, guys, with this foam, you get yourself a rounded corner when you want to shape something. And more rounded than this, but just to show you, and then you can run it back and forward over the round and that will start to pre-bend for like this here. I just kind of rubbed it against the work surface inside to start that bend, and then a bit in the middle. It fits in there pretty well. I've given myself a nice gap, same hump going on, the rear one to do, you know, and then she's starting to look like a board. Just a bit of foam work, easy as can be. Cut that out, stick it on. I just made the hatch out of paper. very boring, so I didn't really film a lot of it. So anyway, that's the blaring out of the way. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, hatch numero uno. Dundee-doed. The cuts are done a certain way through, more than halfway. You want to go if you want more rocker on your board. Now when I push the nose down, you see they all open up. You see that there's normal, and then boom, I can put on what I want. I'm going to try lolly sticks in the holes. Maybe they need to be different thicknesses, but I'll work along. I'll come back and show you that once I've got something going on. Okay guys, I think we could say I got the desired effect. It might be a bit too much, but now that nose, that has got some rocker, baby. It's kind of still a nice sort of line. I'll keep it like that for now. Yeah, I might widen, come down and shorten that nose yet anyway, but there you go. Lolly sticks I used in the end. Underneath there, all those slits I made, just cut the lolly sticks in half, and it worked out fairly well. All you gotta do is make sure you're not twisting the board as you're putting the lolly sticks in. Keep an eye down the front of the board. This actually is twisted, but that's the stands. Once I get it on a completely flat surface, I'll make sure that nose is straight to the board. So yeah, it's starting to look a little bit more badass, guys. Rocking and rolling. All right guys, so I'll be back. Next step, I'm not sure what that is yet, but you'll see, because you'll have the video going on. All right.